I had to make a 3D game in 1 week. Small problem, I've never made a 3D game before. A month ago, I tried an 8-day game jam.
Wait, hold on, what's a game jam?
A game jam is where you have to make a game as fast as you can before time runs out. The theme for this game jam was Don't Stop, which I have no idea how I'm going to use. This particular jam was also focused on making a game that is juicy, which in other words just means it's satisfying to play. Now, I've never made a game in 3D before, so this could really go either way. But it can't be that hard, right? Right? The jam started on a Tuesday at 3 a.m. Now, the smart thing to do would probably be to start immediately and not waste any time. So I completely wasted the first day and I got nothing done. But that's okay because I still have a whole week. Hey, that god guy made the whole universe in a week, so surely I can make a game in the same time. Now, I love shooters. Shooters are sick, especially when you can go fast. So I made a first-person character using this tutorial, but this character isn't affected by physics, which is bad because you can't go fast. So I had to throw away that and make a new character that is affected by physics. So now we have a physics-based character, which I made completely on my own. No, get out of here. After I got the character done, I made a dash move for the player, which works perfectly with no issues. You know what else is sick? Grappling hooks. Now I spent more time than I would have liked on the movement, but I still needed grappling hooks, so I knew I'd have to make it fast. Damn, this sucks. This is just straight up broken. Damn, getting the player all finished took a little while. Let's see how long we have left. Holy shit! I wanted this game to kind of be like Dark Souls, but in first person.
We've kind of made the Dark Souls of competitive first person shooters.
But currently the game has no shooting in it, which is kind of bad for a first person shooter. It's literally in the name. So I started adding a gun into the game. All the best games have a double barrel shotgun in them. It's just a fact. So I found this free low-poly shotgun model from Poly Pizza. Thank you, Quaternius, very cool. I then added sound and particle effects to the gun to make it more juicy. When your mum tells you to shower. But I realized the game still wasn't a shooter, we did have a gun, but there was nothing to shoot at. So I made the first enemy. An Evangelion reference. Now there's a small problem with this guy. He's supposed to fly around, but all he does is sit around all day doing nothing, like me. This is because he has no AI. But I've never made any flying enemy AI before, so...
Manage this at all, it's usually pretty good by default. And Unity also recommends not going over 8 voxels per...
Okay, that, I'm making my own AI.
So I ended up making my own flying AI, and he's kind of dumb, but hey, it gets the job done. The next enemy I made was just a bootleg tac shooter. Come on, it was like 2 a.m. at this point, cut me some slack. Next, the game needed some textures. So I found some free textures online and started adding them to the game, but they just looked a bit off, and... this wasn't working, and this looked weird, and this was just bad. At this point, I just felt like giving up. The enemies weren't fun to fight at all and the game looked disgusting. I knew I couldn't get it done in 2 days. I knew I had to make a decision. Do I give up and throw away all this progress? Or keep going and maybe not even finish it all?
Next, don't be too hard on yourself.
I hadn't come this far to give up now. The enemies were not fun to fight, but using the grappling hook and flying around was, so I pivoted and decided the game wouldn't be about fighting, but instead it would be about finishing levels as fast as you can. I kept the enemies and I made it so the grappling hook works on them too. I also got rid of the environment textures, fixed that ugly ass skybox, and added a little post-processing. Now, goddamn, that sky looks so nice and blue, I just want to drink it all up. I spent the rest of the day fixing all the gameplay bugs I'd found and realized there was no music in the game. Now, without any music, the voices start getting louder, so I started looking for some free music to use, because I still don't know how to make music yet. What do you want from me? At this point, I also realized I could use the theme Don't Stop by adding a timer that records how long you take to beat each level. This should hopefully make people want to beat levels as fast as they can and not stop moving. It was the final day of the jam, and small problem, I don't have any goddamn levels. So I started throwing together some levels using Pro Builder. And I made a tutorial level so you'd all know how to actually play the game. Babe, come over. I can't. I'm stuck in the blue zone. I had a couple hours left before the deadline, so I added some menus and realized I needed a name for the game. So it should be something cool like Momentum Overdrive or Skyrunner or something. Look, okay, it was like 1 a.m. at the time. Now, at this point, my game had very little juice, which was a problem, because that was the whole point of the jam. It's the juice jam. So I added more sound effects, particles, camera shake, damage indicators, and with 1 hour left, I submitted the game. It kind of sucks to waste an hour, but with how long the browser version takes to build, I couldn't risk it. Like, goddamn. In the end, I was really proud with how my game turned out. It scored about 67th of 160, but I think it's kind of rigged anyway because some game called Flopper Shooter beat me and... Never mind, this game is a masterpiece and deserves to win. But I'm not done yet. After the jam, I added more levels, fixed a few bugs, and fixed the dash. Self-doubts aside, I did have fun making this. You can find the game down below if you want to play it, and you don't even have to download it. See if you can beat my best times for all the levels, but I only hear real gamers can do that, so...